Hello everyone, I am going to discuss about an important reagent in organic chemistry, that is osmium tetroxide, which is used to make vicinal diols from an alkene. So this is our osmium tetroxide. If you draw the structure of osmium tetroxide, so this is the osmium tetroxide, and the structure is really like this. So osmium tetroxide is a highly electron deficient compound because of a very high oxidation state of osmium here. So osmium is in plus 8 oxidation state. So it has a tendency to get reduced. So it acts as a powerful oxidizing agent. Now what does it do? So osmium tetroxide, it attacks an electron rich double bond. Okay. It is used for dihydroxylation. Basically, the dihydroxylation means the dihydroxylation of alkenes. Okay, and it gives 1,2 diol. And the stereochemistry, is always seen. That means the OH group, when adds to the alkene bond, they come from the same phase, right? Now we will see some example, right? So if we start with this alkene, this trans alkene, and if we give osmium tetroxide in presence of NMO, so it will give you a cis diol, right? This is a syn 1,2 diol. Okay. Now, what is the function of NMO here? So, what is NMO basically? NMO is, first draw the structure of NMO. So NMO is N-methyl morpholine N-oxide. So basically, this is a morpholine group, and this is a N-methyl and N-oxide, right? So what is the function of NMO? The function of NMO is it regenerates the osmium tetroxide, because in this reaction, when osmium tetroxide reacts with alkene, this alkene gets oxidized and osmium tetroxide gets reduced. So that reduced osmium tetroxide is further converted to this oxidized form with the help of this NMO. Now let us see the mechanism behind the reaction. So we draw, let's take some different color. Okay, I'm taking a black color, right? So basically, starting with some cyclohexene, we treat it with osmium tetroxide. So this is osmium tetroxide. Okay. So the reaction will basically go via a 3 plus 2 cycloaddition type. It will be basically a 3 plus 2 cycloaddition type reaction. So this is basically the mechanism of the reaction. So it forms a complex. This is OS. Okay. Now we have to break this complex. So sometimes we use sodium bisulfide. So sodium bisulfide is basically a coreactant which is used to break this complex. Okay. So we will get a syndial So this is basically syn, because this alkene, so alkene has both the faces. So either the osmium tetroxide from attack can attack from the above face, or it can attack from the below face. So the alternate possibility is also there. Both OH can also be below the face. Okay. So next we will see about the regioselectivity of the reaction. We'll see about the regioselectivity of the reaction. So what does it mean? Let's say we have two double bonds. We have two double bonds. In bond, we have CO2-Me over here, CO2-Me. It can be a cyanide or something, any type of electron withdrawing group can be there, here, electron withdrawing group. Okay. Now you add osmium tetroxide in presence of NMO. So we have two double bonds. So the reaction will be selective. So osmium tetroxide will add to a double bond which is more electron rich, because osmium tetroxide itself is a electron deficient, right? Osmium tetroxide is basically electron deficient. This is highly electron deficient due to the high oxidation state of osmium. So this, so between these two double bond, this double bond is attached to an electron withdrawing group. That means the electron density over this double bond is very less. Whereas the electron density over this double bond is high. So more electron rich here. So since osmium tetroxide is a highly electron deficient compound and it will undergo reduction and it acts as a powerful oxidizing agent, so it will react to a double bond which is more electron rich, because the electron rich double bond will lose that electron to get oxidized. Okay. So the final product will be, this is CO2-Me, CO2-Me, and here we will get OH. So both the OH will be syn, they will be syn. Either they can attack from the below face, or it can attack from the above face, right? Next, we will discuss about the directing effect. So let's choose some different color. Okay, fine. Let's say you have a double bond where we have in the allylic position, we have a OH group, which is above the plane, right? Now you add here osmium tetroxide. Osmium tetroxide in presence of NMO. Now what will happen? Now, there are two possibilities. If the reagent can form a hydrogen bonding, because OH group is a hydrogen bonded group, it can form a hydrogen bonding with the reagent. But if the reagent can form hydrogen bonding, so the reagent will attack from the face where the OH group is present. But in this case, what happens? Osmium tetroxide. So in this case, osmium tetroxide is highly electron deficient compound, right? So being an electron deficient compound, it will pull the electron towards itself from the oxygen atom. So here, the oxygen atom present, or the oxygen atom attached to the osmium tetroxide will be highly electron deficient. So these oxygens are electron deficient. So as you all know, an electron deficient oxygen atom cannot form a hydrogen bond easily, right? So in this case, only the steric factor plays an important role. So since the OH group is above the plane, and due to the steric factor, the osmium tetroxide will attack from the below face. If it becomes like, so it becomes like this. So osmium tetroxide in this case will attack from the below face. So we will get this type of, so this is a triol, but this type of scene dial, so it's a top back face attack since the OH group is above the face. Okay, so here hydrogen bonding is not playing a role because this osmium tetroxide oxygen is very much electron deficient, so it cannot form a hydrogen bond with the OH group. So only the steric factor plays an important role here, right? Now the same reaction, if we carry out the same reaction in presence of, if we carry out the same reaction in presence of osmium tetroxide NMO and T-meta. So if we use osmium tetroxide NMO in presence of T-meta, so what will happen? So basically, the reverse thing will happen. So what is T-meta? First, write what is T-meta. T-meta is tetramethyl ethylene diamine. That means this is our, so this is tetramethyl and this is ethylene diamine. So both the nitrogen has a lone pair, so it can act as a chelate ligand. And we have osmium tetroxide, highly electron deficient osmium tetroxide. So what happens here? This T-meta forms a complex with osmium tetroxide. That means it donates some electron to this osmium tetroxide. Now what happens? This osmium tetroxide becomes somehow electron rich. It becomes somehow electron rich. Not so much rich, but it becomes richer than the earlier case. Okay. Now in this case, this oxygen is also becoming somehow electron rich. Now this oxygen can take part in hydrogen bonding. So if we use T-meta and osmium tetroxide, the hydrogen bonding factor plays the role. So as hydrogen bonding factor plays the role, the OH group over here is above the plane. So osmium tetroxide will also come from the top face because hydrogen bonding factor is favorable here. Okay. So hydrogen bonding plays dominant role over steric factor, right? Okay. So next is, if we use a non-hydrogen bonded compound, like, let's change some color. Taking some orange, take it orange, or you can take red. Looks good. Okay. Now, if you take just, we are replacing the OH group by OMe group. Now, OMe group does not take part in OMe group does not take part in hydrogen bonding. Okay. So in this case, what happens? Only steric factor plays the role, right? So in this case, only steric factor will play the role. That means either you use osmium tetroxide NMO or you use osmium tetroxide NMO in presence of Timeda, you will get the same product, that is the incoming osmium tetroxide, or the final product, that is the incoming OH seen OH group, will be below the face due to steric factor, right? So what we learn from here, so if we have a OH group, so if we use only osmium tetroxide NMO, we will get the opposite steric, like means if the OH group is above the plane, the osmium tetroxide will come from the below face, because here being a hydrogen bonded group, OH group is a hydrogen bonded group, but the osmium tetroxide is highly electron deficient, so it cannot form hydrogen bonding. Okay, so steric factor plays the important role here. But if we use a Timeda with osmium tetroxide, that Timeda will supply some electron to the osmium tetroxide, so makes it more electron rich. Now that osmium tetroxide can form hydrogen bonding with the OH group. In that case, hydrogen bonding plays the vital role. So osmium tetroxide will attack from the top face. But if we use a non-hydrogen bonded compound, non-hydrogen bonded substituent like OMe, so it does not form hydrogen bonding. So only the steric factor plays the role. So either you use osmium tetroxide or you use osmium tetroxide in presence of Timeda, it will end up with the same product. So let's take another example. So this will be the last example I'm going to give. So let's change the color. Okay. So let's say you have a bicyclic compound, right? Let's say you have this compound, bicyclic compound. You have a methyl group over here. Now you have added osmium tetroxide, OSO4, in presence of NMO. So here we have a CH3 group. So only the steric factor plays the important role, because CH3 group cannot form any hydrogen bonding, right? So if we draw the, let's see. Okay, so if you draw the shear conformation, it's very difficult to use one note, right? So if we draw the shear conformation, the CH3 will be here above, right? We have a double bond here. So the CH3 is above. So the osmium tetroxide will come from the below face. Right, so if the osmium tetroxide come from the below face, so the syndiol will be in the below face, right? So the product will be like this, so one OH will be here, another OH will be here. Okay, so if we draw here, same thing, what will happen? So this is our CH3. So this will be our OH group, and this will be our OH group. So here only the steric factor plays the role. Only steric factor plays the role, right? So this is all about this lecture, and in the next video I will be discussing some more reagents like this, like MCBBA, like selenium oxide, MnO2, and many more. So thanks for watching.